Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a quick look at the North American stock markets for Thursday morning. Things are fairly quiet out there. Stock index futures slightly below fair value. Dow futures have been trading between down 20, down 30 points all morning. So not a lot of negativity in the pre-market this morning. One thing to keep an eye on, the Chinese markets might have topped last night. The indexes were down 5, 6% in China. And so if we see fall through to the downside on Friday, we may have seen a top for the Chinese stock market. Now, yesterday was another reversal day. On Tuesday, we reversed to the downside, ran down to support at 2100 on the S&P 500 cash index. And yesterday, we ran right back up to the 2125 level, back to major resistance and stopped. And the last bar of the day actually was a bearish reversal bar. So that could indicate some selling at the open on Thursday morning. Volume, same story. Yesterday was the up day, 90 million shares on the SPDR traded. The previous day was the down day, 119 million shares traded. So again, the weighting is still on the downside. That doesn't seem to present a problem for the market right now, but at some point, I believe it will. Now there's the NASDAQ. This is the headline, new all-time closing high for the NASDAQ. Had a lot to do with chips, semiconductors up nearly 4% on the SOX index. That was led by Broadcom up over 20% on the day. And then, of course, there was some spillover effect. Avago, NVIDIA, Cirrus Logic, all up over 5% on the day. Not everything went up. Coming into yesterday, Michael Kors, the clothing store, it had been on a sell signal since late March, and then yesterday down nearly 25% on the day. So congratulations to anybody shorting that stock. The Dow had an inside day on Wednesday. The S&P 500, slightly higher high. So not an inside day. We still closed within the channel. There's the TSX closing in the middle of the channel yesterday, inside day on Wednesday. The Russell 2000 back on a buy signal. The ZAX microcap still on a sell signal. No change in trend there. No change in trend for bank stocks on both sides of the border. Inside day for the TSX financial services sector. Slightly lower low for the Amex oil and gas index. Lower low for the TSX energy index. Little reversal for some of the mining stocks. The XAU had a bullish reversal day. Didn't take out the previous day's high, and that would be the first sign that something new is happening. And similar situation for the TSX gold index. Last up this morning, looking at indexes, the transports had an inside day on Wednesday, so didn't take out the previous day's high, so no change in direction there. Next up, we're looking at our commodity ETFs, and our commodity tracking ETF continue to move lower. There's copper moving lower. We saw gold down 2 cents. The GLD does just down 2 cents on the day. Platinum continued to move lower, down 70 cents, and silver down 6 cents on the day. Looking at energy, the USO was down 21 cents. Gasoline continued to move higher. And of course, you look for a pop going into the long weekend. And of course, after the long weekend, the demand goes away. And so we're down 91 cents for gasoline. And fairly quiet trading for natural gas, still down 4 cents on the day, still on a sell signal. No change there. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts for the S&P 500 cash index. Looking for an hourly close below 21.1403 to generate an intraday sell signal on Thursday. Again, we ran up to resistance. Last bar of the day was a bearish reversal bar. And so notice that the pros did not take control yesterday. So we had a nice move up, but not enough to tell us that the pros are back in control. There is the TSX closing at the upper channel line. An hourly close below 15,073 would give us a new intraday sell signal on Thursday. For the NASDAQ 100, we need an hourly close below 4507.15. For the SOX index, we need an hourly close below 722.84. And last up, looking at the XAU, getting pretty close to a buy signal here. An hourly close above 68.93 would give us a new intraday buy signal on Thursday. Okay, folks, that is all for Thursday morning. Have a great day, and we'll be back again to talk to you on Friday morning.